Hello, everyone. Today, we will talk about Dynamics 365 Finance and Operations, ERP licensing for Power Platform Admin Center and LCS licensing report. I am Saurabh Kuchal at Microsoft Fast Track team here. In session one, we covered the user license management, what are the license timelines. Session two, we will talk about PPAC and LCS licensing report. The agenda is just two reports, the Power Platform Admin Center report, as well as the LCS user consumption report. Under Power Platform Admin Center, if you go to Licensing Hub, you will see the report for finance and operations. Note the report URL, admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. You can also go to admin.preview.powerplatform.microsoft.com for anything, any upcoming changes which are coming under preview. Let's take a look at the demo. In this demo, we will cover a licensing report for finance and operations under Power Platform Admin Center. I am on the homepage of Power Platform Admin Center. The URL is admin.powerplatform.microsoft.com. On the left, you can see a bunch of tiles here, actions, manage, security, copilot, monitor, deployment, licensing, support. The new licensing report for finance and operations lives under licensing tab. You can go to manage. You can see all the environments over here. You can manage tenant settings here. You can also see support. Under support, you can see support requests, all the logs ones. I also want to take you to the known issues where you can see if any known issues related to licensing. Filtering on licensing, and it should start showing me all the issues active or resolved related to my Dynamics 365 finance and operations licensing related ones. You can see the ones like approval licensing miscalculations, enter ID group ones, human resource availability showing in Power Platform Admin Center. All these are the active ones or some of the resolved ones as well. The licensing report for finance and operations apps. You will see the tiles, five tiles at the top, total users requiring license, unlicensed, under license, over license, and the users without license requirement. Here in the down, you will see for each of the SKU based on the license types and supply chain, finance, e-commerce, you can find out all those things here. Manage the licenses here. Under this, it will take you to Microsoft Admin Center to assign the user licenses to users or user groups. You can export all this data to a CSV. I highly recommend it. So it gives the feature of select report type. You are looking for the standard report or you're looking for the detailed report. And you can download that. You can also see file generated in last 1 day here. Here is how the detailed report looks like. I have applied the filters. Here you can see the report for all your production, all your sandbox environments. I'm just filtering it down for sandbox environments. I can see all my sandbox names, and I can filter it down to particular environment which I'm using to analyze or review my license usage. I can see based on security roles, based on users, based on required licenses, assigned licenses. It's a great way to analyze the data all at one place. Back to these tiles, you can see total users requiring licenses. Here you can see all the users with their emails, what is required licenses, what is assigned licenses in M365 Admin Center, and what is missing for those users. You can see the full list over here. Let's go to unlicensed users. Under unlicensed user, you will see the list of users who are using Dynamics 365. They have assigned roles and they are not having any license assigned. So example on Preston, where it required license for finance and supply chain, and you can also assign the license in M365 Admin Center. If you click on this, it will directly take you to Microsoft 365 Admin Center for that user and on the license apps page where you can assign the licenses. Let's click on that license requirement and understand where it needs the license. As we can see on this page here, we can see what are the environment name, what security roles it has, and what is the required license for each. I see this user has a security role assigned process engineer. For process engineer, under supply chain management premium, this is fully entitled. 846 objects are fully entitled and not entitled to zero. It means supply chain management or SCM premium license for process engineer role fulfill the license requirements. As you can see here for finance, it fulfills 709 and it's missing or not entitled 137 objects which are not entitled under finance license. So now we know it requires finance and supply chain licenses. Let's see what is in missing licenses. Under missing licenses, you can see it the Preston either need the finance base and supply chain attach, or vice versa, supply chain base or finance attach. For under license users, I can see James, it requires a finance license, but it has assigned operations activity license only. It is missing the finance license. Let's understand why it needs the finance required license. We can see under this environment, he has a security role assigned as accountant, and that's why it's looking for the finance license. Just like we can see unlicensed and under-licensed users, we can also see the over-licensed users. There could be scenarios where users have changed roles, they left organizations, or whatever reason. I can take an example of Fiona. She has finance required license, whereas she has assigned, she has been assigned commerce and finance license. If I click on required license, I can see she has production environment access, sandbox environment access, and these are the roles assigned to her. Under production only, these count. For sandboxes, it will say required license as not applicable. This is helpful to know for each user what kind of required license will be in sandbox, but please note you will see word as not applicable over here. As she has account receivable clerk role, and she only required the finance license. You can go to M365 Admin Center and deassign the commerce license to her. We also have a tile for users without a license requirement. There could be users such as system administrator, not need any license. Those are the users you will see in this tile. If you go to Dynamics 365 licensing guide, you will see a FAQ. Under FAQ, you will see the list of 51 roles where users do not require a license. System administrator is part of this list as well. Okay, so we saw the Power Platform Admin Center licensing report. We also get the feedback, I may not have access to that report under Power Platform Admin Center. What you can do, you can also access the same information through Lifecycle Services, LCS. You will see a new file called User License Consumption, and this report will take you to very similar information like you saw in the Power Platform Admin Center. Let's take a look at the demo. Under LCS, you can also see the list of all the users who have license required, what is license assigned, and what is missing licenses for them. I'm taking example of Scarlett. She needs the supply chain management required as required license. I can click on that. Once I click on it, I can see maintenance manager security role, and that's why she needs supply chain management license. Further click on maintenance manager role, and I can see the details for maintenance manager, very similar to PPAC, that under SCME license, it has entitlement of all the roles or work other type of roles such as activity. It's only meeting 472 objects. Thank you so much for your time. See you on the next one.